This
structure
conference will now be recorded.
The Apache POI is used for writing this particular codes. The Apache POI architecture had changed, that's why I did not take a session yesterday. Now I've created the particular keyword based on certain behaviors. One is we have to first create a workbook. Then you have to create a sheet inside. Workbook is nothing but the Excel workbook. Then you have to create a sheet, then a row, then a cell. Cell means column. So the agenda goes like this. You have to create a workbook first, then create a sheet, create a row, create a column, which is nothing but a cell. Put the value inside the column. And then write the Excel sheet to the file system. So the first thing is that create a workbook. I've created a private variable right now, get workbook, and return type is XSSF workbook class. It returns an object of the XSS workbook class. Then you create a sheet. In the sheet, I've created a method called getSheet method, which returns the XSSF sheet class. And the arguments are your the reference of the XSS workbook and the sheet name. It returns the sheet by creating a sheet using the create sheet method of the XSSF workbook class. This is a method of the XSSF workbook class. And you define the sheet name out here. Then this is the keyword actually to write in the Excel sheet. It has certain arguments, the Excel path where you want to create an Excel, the sheet name, the value that you want to write down, the index number of the row and the index number of the column. The first thing is that you are using the get workbook method, which returns a object of the XSS workbook class. So get workbook returns a object of the this particular class. This is creation of the workbook. Next thing, you have to create the sheet. So I have used this particular get sheet method, get sheet. Then you pass on the book, this book out here. So create sheet will require you to pass on the workbook that is represented by the reference variable book and the sheet name which comes from here. Return type of get sheet method is also a object of the XSSF sheet class. Okay. And then you create the row. So XSSF sheet class has a method called the create row method. So sheet dot create row and the row number which comes from here. Return type XSSF row. This is creating a row. And then the row, XSSF row class contains a method called create cell. This is create a column. The column name will come from here when you call this particular function. Return type of create cell method is XSSF shell. Okay, and there is one more method called the write to the file system. The last part of it, write to the Excel, write the Excel to the file system. So there's a method down. Write to the file system will take the XSSF workbook reference and the string of the Excel path. You use the file input stream of the Java class, create an object of that, and the constructor will take the Excel path. And the write method is the method of the XSSF workbook class. This will write down with the file input stream reference. And then file input stream has to be closed. So a out.close. And if this invokes an exception, write method invokes an exception, which is handled by the keyword utilities classes, which is a class of your Catalan mark error. This will convert the exception to a string and throw out the result if the exception is caught. So this is the this write to file system will be called inside this particular method called as write to Excel file. Now you can use this method for writing. So write to Excel is the keyword. You can go to test cases. Excel writing is already out there. So here what I can do is that let me remove this first. First, I'll open the browser. So what I will do is that let me open up, let's say Rediffmail. Account. So whatever I write down in the username and password, I can actually capture it and put it to the Excel sheet. So let me first go to this particular website. Maximize the window. Navigate to this URL. And the URL will be and then we can give a delay. Let's say of 10 seconds. And then I will write on this username. So for that I need basically a object repository. So I'll basically create a new folder, Excel writing. And this will be your another folder called as landing page. In this, I'll create a test object. I'll call this test object as username. Read box. And pick up the XPath of this. Okay, I'm going to go to your Excel writing. And this is set the text to read box, and what is the value that you want to set? I want to set the value as 10. Let's give it a delay for this. And when you write this particular value and then you do an inspection, so can I get the text? I'll get the text out here. Get text method is there. Get the text from the same username, right? And I'll create a variable. Add a variable. Adding a variable is always a problem. What is the problem? I'll give the variable name a uname, not var. String type default name is need not be defined. Save it and the manual mode. In the output, let's go to the script mode. What it says is you have put the value to a variable. So let's sys out this. System.out.println. Control C the variable value. So let's run this first to check out that it is throwing out the variable value or not. Okay, the uname. So this should be, you should get by the getText method and you should be able to print out in the variable. Let's see that. Uname. Get text method, you're getting the text a bit, putting it to a variable. Print it out. Yeah. that's also not working, then we can see some other thing. Probably console result. Print out of mode. I mean, where is the printout of this? It is passing. The get text method is not able to get the text of it. Okay, so what we can do is that let's go to the script mode, manual mode. There is something called as get attribute. So I will get the attribute of the ID, which is equal to login one. Okay. Get text method is not able to use it, so I will use the get attribute of the username field when I need to give the attribute of the ID and put to the username variable that you have defined and print out that. So we can system.out.println. Login one. So you can see login one is coming. So get text method is not able to get the text. That is a different story, the why it is not able to get the text. Okay. But you are getting the value, and the value of the output variable, whatever is the value of the get attribute method, get attribute ID, that you have kept to a variable right now. Now this variable value login one that I have shown you can be printed out in the Excel. The motive to show you how to print out in Excel. So what I can do is that I can basically add the custom, not here, add the down custom write Excel file, and this requires you to give the Excel path. So Dave, where do you want to keep the Excel path? Let's say I want to keep the Excel path in this Catalan. See users, Lenovo Cat Desktop Catalan. I want to keep the Excel out here, copy. Go give the Excel path. And please don't forget to put the Excel file name, test data, right, dot XLSX. Then the sheet name. You should give the sheet name out here. So let's say I'll call the sheet name as write data. Then what is the value that you want to? The value will come from the variable. Which variable? Uname variable. This one. And index number 0, and for the row, index number 0 for the column. Okay. So I can save this and run this. After that, it will pick up the attribute value of the ID attribute login, print out the variable, and then that login one should be kept in the Excel file in 0th index of the row, 0th index of the column. So let's see that it has passed. I can see it. Let's go out here, test data, right? Create the Excel sheet. Open this up. Write data is the sheet name I had given. It doesn't write down. That is the question. Everything else is does. It doesn't write down. Why? Same problem. See, you can see that it has created the Excel sheet. It has created the sheet name. Write data login one. I created given this uname is the variable and the variable value is getting printed out here. 1 minute. Variable value is this printed out. Okay, if I give any string value, hi, hi should be printed out, right? So the whole script is working based on the it is Excel sheet is getting created on that path. Sheet name is getting created. The string value. The string value. Writing is happening. Otherwise, the sheet name wouldn't have got created. Write to the file system book. File output stream. One minute. Let me remove this first. Remove the file output. Is the package. Let's run it. Again, but I want to type. I have typed down high. If you look at, I have typed high. So is that getting printed out? Okay, let me close this. Unstable is Apache boy. If I write down in first index for sure. Creates me use in Eclipse. Because the code works in Eclipse, should work in Catalan Studio. It is creating the Excel sheet. It is creating the sheet name. Write data. Why is it basically not putting the data? Okay, let me try to create it out here. I will Excel write. I added these jar files also in your Catalan Studio. Oh, this has to be a static method. I have to pass on the path, right? I'll give the same path. Test data load x lsx. Then I have to give the sheet name. Write data is the sheet name. Value. Hi. Need to give the value, so give the value of I. Index number one for the row, index number one for the column. Run this. Same, not writing down. I don't know if it is a problem with this particular jar file or not. Stop. Import. Open CSV. 1 minute. Cell dot set cell Set the cell value. Greater row. Let me check up now. Desktop Catalan. Hi, great. So it is writing down. So I just forgot to give this particular value. Good. Set the cell value, I completely forgot. Okay. So what I can do is right now is that let me close all these things. Okay, so what I can do is that I can go back to this particular code. Let's save this. I go back to this particular code out here, and here I have given the as high, right? So this I have to change it to variable, and I'll give the user name. So the u name variable value will come from the get attribute method. ID value will be login one, and that will be printed out. The next thing that I want to do, I want to print out in the 0th row, 0th index of the row, and the 0th index of the column. Okay, and I can go and remove this again. Or I can create one more. What is there? We'll call this as test data only. Save it and you can run this. And then go out here, test data. And the zeroth index of the row, zeroth index of the column means the first cell, login one, printed out. Okay, this is how you write down. So now I'll show you how to read. For reading, you don't have to create anything. Writing is very difficult. You have to create your own keyword. If you do not know Apache Py, you will not be able to do it. And Apache Py architecture has completely changed. It took me 4 hours to create this particular code. So what I can do right now is Excel reading. I can go to the same area, that is your Catalan Studio. Here only I'll create Excel sheet first. Okay, generally I will read it from here. I'll read from here and then write here. That is the motif. So, username and password, right? So the first column will be username. Second column will be password. And this is the username that I will pick up. The password is test at the rate 1234. Save it out. So reading involved this, so I'll just copy certain parts of it. Control C. Create a test case. Okay, first what I need to do is I'll show you there's a data files. You create the data file, create a folder inside it, and wait for rediff mail data. Inside this, you can create a test data and I call this as credential data. And you can pick up data from an external file, which can be an Excel file. It can be a CSV file, database data, or internal data. So I'm using Excel file. Say OK. You have to browse for the file name. OK, one more thing before I. The sheet name I will rename is to read data sheet. I'll browse out here, browse and go to the desktop Catalan reading Excel. And not only the sheet name, if there are multiple sheet names, the multiple sheet name will come out here. This is the sheet name. And if you look at this Excel sheet, the Excel sheet contains the first row as the header. So if the first row is the header, then you can go out here and check this. Use first row as the header. Okay. And you can see the username and password has come automatically. Right. Save this. Once you have done that, you go to your you have to have object repository also created. And I'll create a new object repository for read Excel. And a new folder called as landing page. Rediff mail. New test object, I'll call this as username. Read box. Pick up the expert. Navigate to URL, delay of 10 seconds, and then you have to set the text. Username, edit, this will be your different one. This is Excel writing. You have Excel reading also, read Excel. And here the data will come from test data value. And this is the credential data. The data source I have created it. Okay, this is the data source I have created, credential data. Here delay again, then again set. After delay again set text. On the password. And this again, this will be your test data value. And this is the credential data. This is how you can read data from Excel sheet or from a CSV file also it is possible. From a database also it is possible. You can save it and you can run it. So you'll read the data from the Excel sheet. So he's reading the data from the Excel sheet. And password test at the rate 1234. Why so many are coming? So I need to check out. This is your first row. first column, if you look at the Excel sheet, this will consider the first row, first column. This is the first row, second column, right? This is first row, second column, because this is the first row is taken as the header. This is the first row. So first row, first column is fine for the username. First row, first column is fine for the username. First row, first column. But for the password, it cannot be first row, first column. This could be the second column. And this. Now it is fine, first row, second column. And then what you can do is at the last, you can click on the go button to see that. Why go button? To check if it is going to the inbox or not. If the first row, first column is selenium, first row, second column is this, then you can click on go button. It should go to the inbox. It is going. You can see that. So you can. Copy the XPath of this, go out here. And you can run it. It's working fine. So that's the Excel reading. But one more thing I'll show you. This Excel contains only one data. If you have multiple datas, multiple datas means what? You have to go test at the rate 1, 2, 3, 4. You click on the go button. Better you click on the logout. Okay, and this is the URL of your navigate to the same URL again. So after click method, you have to log out and then navigate to the URL for using the second data. Second data means if you have a second row. Okay, so for that, I will give you a different behavior. This is not defined in your curriculum, but let me show you. So I'll give you a correct username. Any more username I have, I don't know. Let me check out. Shit. EN4D. X7. No, that is what I'm going to put out here.
Okay, log out.
Because I'll have to create a different retrieval data.
I'll create this as
Baba.
Yeah, it has come. Both the data have come, and you can go out here. Click on the go button and I will close the it will go to the inbox. They have a delay of 5 seconds, and after that you can have a close the browser directly. Okay, and then you have to navigate this URL once more. Okay, this is fine. Let me go to the script mode. If you look at out here, there is multiple data. Okay, so what you need to do is that test data, data is equal to, where is the data source?
data. You have to give the path out. And then you have to use a for loop. Okay. Now, if you use data dot get row numbers, you can see they turned up as an integer. Integer x is equal to this. This will give you the number of row numbers. So for loop, so you can start with integer index is equal to 0. Index is a variable. And I'll call this as I should be less than data dot get row number. And I++. This whole code that you have, please put it inside this for loop. And if you will understand it, this is the username. This is the row. Row, replace it by I. That's all. So you define the data comes in the data variable. You can get the number of variable row numbers. If you want to see the number of row numbers, you can just do system.out.println and print out the value of x. And if I remove this code, you can at least get the value of the number of rows in this data, in this Excel sheet rather. Okay, which is defined in this data source. Run this. Number of rows are 2. If you look at this Excel sheet, number of rows are 2. Because the first row is the header, right? Number of rows are 2. If the number of rows are 2, index number will start at 0 and end at 1. Because the value of this, I'll put it, the value of this is right now 2. So it starts with 0 is less than 2. Run this, then I will be incremented to 1. 1 is less than 2, we'll do the same thing. Then I becomes 2, 2 is not less than 2. The for loop will stop running. Go to this Excel manual view, you will see like this for loop. This is how you can see the for loop being used also. I don't have to show it separately like this. If you want to see the for loop statement, you can actually get it from here. Loop statement, for loop statement. So when you want to give the for loop statement, these are the arguments. Variable is this. I is equal to 0. Expression, object type is variable. You can see that. Closure, it's a closure list. Okay. And I is equal to 0, I is less than data dot get row numbers and dot I++. This is how you can create the for loop from the manual mode, not from the scripting mode. You don't have to show the for loop again. Okay, and you can go out here and run this. This will do nothing. Basically run this whole script 2 times because there are 2 rows.
So it will basically go, the first time it runs, it will take the value of I is equal to 0. That means and it will run. Let us see, what does it take? A file problem. I'm able to navigate to. सेशन है अच्छी में कट बोलो कैटलॉन है अच्छी I will change it with I. So what is the problem? Browser not opened exception. Not close the browser. Go button click delay. Oh, there's no open browser. Oh shit. Somehow I've forgotten. So before this, that is what I was thinking. What is happening? Insert before this web UI. Open browser. And then insert before this web UI. Maximize window. Then you can navigate to the URL. Open browser, maximize navigate to window, and then you can use the whole structure out here, right? Then I can copy this. Control X, put it inside the for loop. So it will close the browser, again it will open the browser and do the same thing. Let's run this one. Set text method. And where is the failure? Row index 0 is invalid. So that means the crux of the matter is that if you go to the script view, index starts with 1 should be less than equal to the, there are two rows, right? Then it should run. Yeah, okay. Password. Click on go. And close the browser. Now again open the browser. Kaushik now. Kaushik.mukherjee. It has failed. Why? Invalid row index number 2 are for the test data. Row must be between 1 to 1. Run it. It opens these for the second time. I can understand that. Let's see. run data for the first run. It does not run for the second time. Get row numbers to. So when I is 1, it takes 1 is less than 2, because the value of this printout is 2. So 1 is less than 2. If I look at the data source, it is zero, one, start at. Second index, this should start at 1, that's fine. 1 is less than 2. Then I is incremented to 2. 2 is less than equal to 2. So if this is 2, I value will be 2. 2 is, I is incremented to 2. 2 is less than equal to 2. Fine. The logic should run because first row, first index of the first column, it is setting up as first column, first row. That is this one. Second column, first row. Second column, first row means this. Then again, first column, second means this, first column, second. It should work now. So 1 should be less than equal to 2. Let's run this. This is not defined in the curriculum. I'm just trying to show you when you want to run with multiple datas, multiple rows rather. I is equal to 2, 2 is less than 2, the value of I becomes 2. I don't use a for loop. I give this value of I as 2. From the same data source. Let's see. Here I row index 2. Get value of the column name. First row, first column. This is first row, second column. I give row 2, column 1. This simple way, why it is not working? Simple thing it is. This should second take the second row data. Second row column 1, second row column 2. value of this is equal to 2. Data dot get get bytes, get x plus y. This will be the row number, this will be the column numbers. Let me run this. Two rows, two columns. Column is by J. Okay, I'll have to look at this. I'll let you know tomorrow, but let's move forward with the Jenkins installation. Because this is, I don't know why it is not working, because the number of rows it will get giving you two. And even if you basically do not use the inner for loop, strictly speaking, you have this column fixed at okay, 1 minute. Control Z, Control Z. I didn't change the I out here. I is for the row, J is for the columns. 1 and 1. First row, first column. This is constant at 1 and 2. First column, second column. I is first row, first column, second row. I becomes 2, 2 less than 2. One of one, two of one. That is where it is failing. So what is the value of invalid row index 2 for test data? See, invalid row index 2 index is 1, print out. So set the text with 2, 1, 2, or 2, 1. Then it is 2. Invalid row index 2 for test data. I make this equal to I'll try the last time for this. If not happens, I'll let you know tomorrow, but I'll show you the Jenkins integration. First, download Jenkins and set it up. Fine, this is fine. Until here, it is fine. Click there. It has elapsed because 1 is less than 2. 2 is not less than 2. Make it equal to 0. Call this I plus 1. No run. Because from index number 0, it is not taking because the first row is the header. So that is why index number 0 has not been taken. So it is starting in index number 1. So I've started with 0, but I've made that as y is equal to I plus 1. Because it takes from 1, right? To start with index number 0, run it 2 times, I have to make I equal to I plus 1. I plus 1, that is what it is. Let's see. Open browser. Now I want to see. There's some mistake happening. And what is the configuration problem? Invalid row index 2. If I start an index number 0, nothing is there. And zero, nothing is there. Okay, let me come back to you regarding this. Okay, before this, I will show you the installation of Jenkins, because tomorrow I will basically show you this particular behavior, because this is important, multiple rows. I'll show you Jenkins integration, but before that, today I will show you the installation of Jenkins. So what you need to do is that, let me close everything. I'll go to C drive, users, Lenovo, Jenkins, delete this. Okay, if you can go out here, you can go to download Jenkins. Jenkins is a continuous integration pipeline tool, basically using DevOps technologies. I don't know if you guys have used in DevOps. Are you guys using DevOps technology?
No, Kaushik, we are not.
There are advanced versions of it. If you scroll down, you will see the long-term support version. Okay, there's a WAR file. Okay, I can download this WAR file. Cut this WAR files, and let's say in the C drive you create a folder by the name of Jenkins, like this folder, and paste that WAR file. Replace it. This is the current one. Now you have to install this WAR file. For installation, I'll show you what you need to do. You have to go to your, I'll show you, REST API desktop. Okay, you have to fire this particular command, java hyphen jar jenkins war. Okay, so first thing is that you have to go to the command prompt, and this is where you have kept your war file. C drive, here, take this path, paste it to your Jenkins and fire this particular command I showed you some time back. The command is called as the Jenkins command for installation of Jenkins. It's an open source tool where you can create builds at runtime, at a specified time. All those things are possible with this. So this command is java hyphen jar, that means run the jar file, jenkins.war. And the port number is 1990. Don't put port number 8080. 8080 is by somebody else. This will be starting the Jenkins server. So you can just copy this and paste it out here. So java space hyphen jar, and this jar file you want to load, and double hyphen, port number on which you want to install Jenkins. 1990, don't use 8080. It will be used by your IIS port. Information in services of your Windows will use 8080 port. Click on enter. You should have your internet. Allow access. Okay, you can see Jenkins initial setup is required. An admin user has been created and a password generated. Please use the following password. So hold on.
You can copy this. Mark copy. So that's your first time password. I'll just copy this and let me see the. Okay. So I need to go to your browser and just write down http://localhost. http://localhost. /localhost:9090. So unlock Jenkins to ensure Jenkins is securely set up by the admin. Password has been written. This is the password that I copied sometime back. Copy it and paste it out here. Click on continue. Please check the file for the correct password. Mark. Control C. Go to your control V. Should not be any space there. Initial password, blah blah. Okay, if it is not working, you can go out and terminate it. Control C to terminate. Okay, and I need to go to C drive once more. Users, Lenovo.Jenkins, remove this. CD2 C drive Jenkins Control C CD Control V paste. And then you have to fire that command to install it once more. As that. It will be 1990 port only. Thank you. See, this may be also found to see users Lenovo, dot Jenkins, secrets, initial admin password. You can go out here also. See users Lenovo, dot Jenkins. Secrets initial password. Copy. Go out here and open up localhost 1990. Don't close your this thing. You can see Jenkins is fully up and running. You should see this message before you open up this particular. http://localhost:9090. So much time to open. Close everything. Thank you. 2006, so much time. Augmented all extensions attempt to defining beans install setup wizard. Let it wait. Finish download metadata. I've still not got the Jenkins fully up and running. I've got it now. So you can go to your C drive users, Lenovo, Jenkins, secrets. Unlock Jenkins. Install suggested plugins. Click out here. All these plugins will be installed.
আছে
These are the plugins getting installed. You can see out here, and in this is a log file. Log file will also show you the plugins are getting installed. These are default plugins.
Hello, Kaushik.
Yeah.
How long will it take? Because it's almost 6. We need to leave.
I have to finish up.
It's more than 2 hours.
I have to finish up Jenkins today. Installation at least.
So how long will it take?
Another 15-20 minutes.
Can you just continue it tomorrow? Because we had already discussed that we can't continue like till 6.
No,
we need to leave at 6.
I cannot stop the installation right now. So just do the installation, then you can go ahead. It might finish before 20 minutes.
Okay. Okay,
stop
fine.
And can you tell me what are the other things that I have not taught you?
Yeah, Kaushik.
What are the other things that I have not covered as part of the curriculum?
It's just that things are getting dragged. Now consider for a calendar that issue. It took more than like 3 days. Till now, we haven't got an answer for that. And also, for mail.
But I'm still solving it out. It is a difficult way to solve it out. Because in Java, it is working.
Okay.
In Kotlin, it is not working.
Okay,
see, for
fine.
Certain codes in Java, it works. Kotlin is based on Java. But the same code in Kotlin, it is not working. So I'm finding a way out for it. Nothing else. Anything else that I have not solved? Until now,
Thank
you think that I should
no it? Next no what I'm telling is it's like before you take us a session you just know that all things are working because abhi like it's like you are checking here and some things are not getting resolved to resolve that thing the entire
I'll tell you Tasmiya and Nilufa what happens.
Okay,
today for example, yesterday I was using Selenium 141.59. Today I went for the particular in my office only. I'll tell you when I went for that. Okay, the clients, the basically 14.1.59, they have deprecated one of the methods. So I had to use on the fly Selenium 4 released yesterday, day of yesterday only. सो ऑन दी फ्लाई कभी कभी क्या होता है कि काम नहीं करता क्योंकि कुछ कुछ मेथड्स वो डिप्रिकेट कर देते हैं कुछ कुछ मेथड्स वो नया मेथड्स क्रिएट करते हैं तो जैसे अपाचे पॉय का जैसे आपका रीडिंग का हुआ दिस रीडिंग एक्सेल
ओके
मेथड दैट आई क्रिएटेड इनसाइड दैट कीवर्ड ड्रिवन वाज ऑलवेज आई यूज्ड टू क्रिएट बिफोर ऑन लाइक दैट बट क्या हुआ कि अपाचे पॉय 4.0.0 दैट इज द लेटेस्ट वर्जन आई हैव यूज्ड फॉर योर ट्रेनिंग Now, वहां पे क्या हुआ है कि एक पर्टिकुलर मेथड कॉल्ड एज सेट रो दे हैव डुप्लीकेटेड एंड आई यूज दैट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर स्टेटिंग आई थॉट दैट द मेथड डुप्लीकेट नहीं होगा इसलिए मैंने वो यूज किया उस दिन काम नहीं कर रहा था इसलिए आई हैड टू गो थ्रू द होल एपीआई डॉक्यूमेंटेशन कि क्या प्रॉब्लम है Apache boy ka kya problem 4.0
okay fine Kaushik and also you told last week our whatever syllabus is there will be completed but last week let me just complete Kaushik last week you told it will be completed but what was the problem was you were unwell Tuesday it's okay fine we do understand but Wednesday Thursday and Friday without informing to us we were waiting for you to take a session and there was no response from you
acha wo mera fault hai main manta hu mera problem hai ki main bhul jata hu isliye main bar bar aapko bolta hu ki mere ko ek bar ping kariye aap log mere ko yaad aa gaya to main khud hi kar deta hu लेकिन कभी कभी मैं इतना घुस जाता हूँ अपने प्रोजेक्ट में क्योंकि मैं आठ आठ प्रोजेक्ट हैंडल कर रहा हूँ कभी कभी भूल जाता हूँ मैं माई ओनली रिक्वेस्ट टू यू अगेन यस अर्लियर ऑल्सो आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट मेरे को प्लीज आप एक बार ट्रिंक करिए लास्ट मोमेंट में ट्रिंक करेंगे मैं इमीडिएटली भेज दूंगा मैं मेरा प्रॉब्लम वहीं पे है इट इज नॉट ओनली प्रॉब्लम विद the professional affairs, I have the same problem in my personal affairs also. I keep on forgetting. And that is why I get a beating from my wife also. So I would request you, agar maan lo 3:30 baje tak aapko nahi milta hai, mainko immediately call kariye, SMS kariye. Kya hai, aapne kyu link nahi diya?
Okay, fine. Next, what, like, देखो अभी कैलेंडर का वैसे ड्रैग हुआ, फिर ईमेल, ईमेल थिंग टू सेंड एन ईमेल एंड रेस्ट ऑल थिंग्स, इवन दैट टुक मोर टाइम. आई एम नॉट टेलिंग लाइक यू आर नॉट डूइंग इट और एनीथिंग लाइक दैट, बट आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग थिंग्स आर गेटिंग ड्रैग बिकॉज ऑफ विच इवन वी आर आंसरेबल टू आवर मैनेजमेंट दैट they are just asking because our training started on September 6th.
Asal mein kya hai, Kashmir and Nilufar, before the start of the training, I had told these guys ki aap 15 din kyu commit kar rahe ho? Ye kam se kam 2.5 se 3 mahine ka training hai, itna course hai. Ek ek do do 10 10 section nahi.
Yeah, but they had told us that it will be somewhere around 25 to 30 hours of session.
Nahi,
our management. अरे जो हमको भेजा है ना डॉक्यूमेंट वो मैनेजमेंट वही बोल रहे हैं, इवन दैट इज द फाइनल थिंग, एंड दे आर आस्किंग लाइक, हाँ दे आर आस्किंग लाइक यू आर जस्ट वेस्टिंग आवर टाइम बिकॉज दे आर पेइंग अस एंड इट्स लाइक यू पीपल आर वेस्टिंग योर टाइम, वी आर आंसरेबल टू जस्ट देम ना, तो हमें भेजना ही क्यों था कि जस्ट इट्स लाइक 25 टू 30 आवर्स.
वो उन्होंने गड़बड़ किया, मैं पहले से मैं बोल चुका था उनको कि इतना कम मत भेजिए, आप रियल टाइम भेजिए, क्या है पता नहीं.
Anyway, it's like that. If they would have told us that it would take 60 hours or something like that, even we would have prepared. But because they have sent it like that, management is asking us why it is taking so long time.
हम लोग से असल में ट्रेनर लोग से ये सब पूछना चाहिए, वो खुद ही कर देते हैं.
Then even you do understand that even yeah, we yeah. are answerable to our management.
Yeah, yeah. मुझे पता है, इसीलिए I wanted to understand कि देखो couple of things जो मैं बोल रहा हूँ. आपका भी the state of your training is I'll tell you. The state of your training is at this particular level. Jenkins करवा रहा हूँ अभी. अभी Jenkins के बाद आपको और एक होगा, that is your Jenkins होने के बाद I'll show you that multi दो एक्सेल शीट वाला मल्टी रो, वो दिखाने के बाद जेनकिंस का कल मैं दिखाऊंगा. अभी तो सेटिंग हो गया है मोस्ट ऑफ इट. सम पाइपलाइन गिटहब आर नॉट गेटिंग इंस्टॉल, दैट्स फाइन, कुड कंटिन्यू विद इट. सेट अप द यूजर नेम पासवर्ड. सो जेनकिंस के बाद आपका रहेगा वेब टेबल, दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट आई विल शो यू. कौशिक एक्चुअली उसके बाद वी कैन जंप टू योर मोस्ट ऑफ द एडवांस एनालिटिक्स जो है, एनालिटिक्स दिखा के वी कैन जंप टू मोबाइल पार्ट. सो दिस इज योर यूआरएल, स्टार्ट यूजिंग जेनकिंस. नेक्स्ट टाइम यू हैव टू लॉग इन, यू हैव टू लॉग इन विद द यूजर नेम दैट आई हैव गिवन, कौशिक, एंड कौशिक इज द पासवर्ड. You do at your end. Okay, I need to go to manage Jenkins. First thing.
Kaushik, can we have this session tomorrow?
Okay, abhi install ho gaya, kal main further chalenge.
Further process you can share tomorrow. We'll also install from our end.
Aap install kar lijiye, jaise bhi hai. Karke uske baad we'll move forward. I have to show you installation of Catalan Studio plugin. Catalan ka से रन करना है ना.
ओके
वो दिखा के जेनकिंस खत्म हो गया तो वेब टेबल दिखाऊंगा और कैटलॉग एनालिटिक्स दिखाऊंगा, उसके बाद मोबाइल पर.
फाइन कौशिक, ओके
आप बुरा मत मानना, मैं भी बुरा नहीं माना हूँ क्योंकि इनका गड़बड़ी है.
नो लुक कौशिक, द प्रॉब्लम इज हियर द मैनेजमेंट इज आस्किंग अस टू शो द रिजल्ट. Okay, and they are asking daily you are spending so much of time on your training. What are you doing? What are you doing? Show it us live. Sir, they are telling us to show. I tried doing that upload file. There also I got an error. I was about to ask you for that. Apart from these training sessions, can you make out some more time for solving errors and other things?
There is a देखिए ये ट्रेनिंग खत्म, मैं पहले भी बोला हूँ ट्रेनिंग खत्म हो जाए दैट इज नॉट द डील। एट द पर्सनल लेवल इफ इफ यू हैव टाइम आई हैव टाइम आई विल सेट अप दिस मीटिंग आई विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व योर केसेस।
ओके कौशिक, दैट इज व्हाट वी एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम यू। थैंक यू फॉर योर सपोर्ट।
नहीं आप चिंता मत करो इतना इतना नहीं है कि
The burden is from our management. They are like, what is happening daily? सुबह में एक बार अपडेट देना है, शाम में एक बार अपडेट देना है. They are asking to show us the result, and we are also under pressure that कैसे बताएंगे बोल के. तो this is the thing. If you are supporting.
December 4th के बाद. December 4th के बाद मेरा timing फिर change हो जाएगा. तो फिर मैं सुबह की आऊँगा.
ठीक है, no problem.
उतना दिन तो आई होप बाय डिसंबर 4th वी विल बी यू नो गेटिंग ओवर विद द मोबाइल आल्सो। मोबाइल में कुछ दिखाना नहीं है खास। तो उसके बाद भी जब आपका प्रॉब्लम्स होएगा वी कैन सिट डाउन एनी टाइम इन द मॉर्निंग फ्रॉम आई विल बी अवेलेबल फ्रॉम 9 o'clock अंटिल 3 o'clock अगेन एनी टाइम
श्योर
सॉल्व इश्यूज व्हाटएवर यू फेस आई विल सिट डाउन। यू डोंट हैव टू बेसिकली से दैट कि एक्स्ट्रा डोंट आस्क दिस गाइस सिलेनियम लैब्स गाइस। ये बोलेंगे जैसे ही मेरे को बोलेंगे जैसे पता चलेगा कि हाँ आप क्या उनके प्रोजेक्ट में जा रहे हो तो बोलेंगे कि आपने चार्ज किया है।
The way Poonam replies is too harsh. even for the YouTubes, what she does is she delays every time for the training. Even we need to practice, right? So we don't get the no videos on time. So because of that, again it is delayed. So whenever we have free time. We tend to practice, but we don't have video with us. That is the reason. So we request again, Poonam, if she is listening to the video, please share us the video on time so that we can practice and be ready for the next session.
अच्छा, मैं जब आपको help कर रहा हूँ, मान लो project में कहीं पे आप stuck हो रहे हो, मैं आपको help कर रहा हूँ, please do not say to Selenium Labs, क्योंकि वो मेरे को question करेंगे, आपके उसके लिए charge कर रहे हो उनको, project आप help कर रहे हो, इसलिए बोलना नहीं।
हाँ, ठीक है, ठीक है।
नौटंकी करेंगे फिर।
Yeah, okay. Thank you, Kaushik, for the support.
No problem.
You do understand our problem as well.
I understood it. That's why, see, I did not say anything in the beginning of the thing, beginning of today's.
Right. Beginning of the session, you didn't tell anything. We got to know that. So, okay. Thank you for understanding, Kaushik.
I understand it. I'm also working on understanding. But try to tell your, your. मैनेजमेंट ये ओपन सोर्स है, ये कभी कभी आर्किटेक्चर चेंज करते हैं, नया नया वर्जन रिलीज करते हैं, तो वो थोड़ा ढूंढने में थोड़ा मेथड ढूंढने में टाइम लग जाता है। जैसे अभी मैं आपका जो रीडिंग एक्सेल का जो क्रिएट किया हूँ दैट इज ऑन अपाचे 4.0.0 लेटेस्ट वर्जन। कल अगर 5 वर्जन आता है सेम कोड वर्क करेगी नहीं पता नहीं मेरे को, देन यू हैव टू कम बैक टू मी अगेन, मेरे को फिर से रीड करना पड़ेगा।
करेक्ट करेक्ट,
ठीक है
ठीक है कौशिक, ओके। सो इट इज द एंड ऑफ द सेशन नाउ। थैंक यू,
द एंड ऑफ सेशन कल यहीं से हम लोग शुरू करेंगे।
फाइन फाइन फाइन, थैंक यू कौशिक, थैंक यू फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, बाय।